Today I am going to discuss about the surface chemistry. Surface chemistry is a part of second year chemistry, second year intermediate. In this surface chemistry, we deals with the surface phenomena. You know, there are so many processes that occur at the surface or interface. So about those changes, we mainly focus in this chapter. So surface chemistry deals with the changes that occur at the surface or interface. This chapter, weightage of this chapter for IP 6 marks, for Eamcet 1 bit, for mains also one question will be given from this chapter. Can you say some examples that occur at the surface? Surface, interface. What is the difference? Surface. Which compounds have surface? Generally, solids and liquids, they have a surface. Gaseous substances, they do not have surface. What is interface? It is also the area of contact, surface of contact, between two bulk phases. Bulk phase means that may be a pure substance or solution. Okay, surface of contact or area of contact between two phases is called interface. Area of contact between two phases is called what? Interface. Surface or interface is denoted by a hyphen or a slash. For example, see, interface between solid and liquid is denoted by solid hyphen liquid or solid/liquid. This hyphen or this slash indicates what? This hyphen or slash indicates interface between two phases. Now let's see the examples which occur at the interface or surface. Adsorption. It occurs at the surface. Heterogeneous catalysis. Corrosion. Next, formation of colloids. Cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Electrode processes, etc. These are some examples that occur at the surface or interface. See, adsorption, heterogeneous catalysis. About catalysis, we have an idea. The process of using a catalyst in a reaction mixture is called catalysis. If reactants and catalyst used are in different phases, that is said to be heterogeneous catalysis. That is also a surface phenomenon. Corrosion occurs at the surface. Formation of colloids. These are also interface phenomenon. Cleansing action of soaps. Interface phenomenon. Cleansing action of soaps and detergent. Interface phenomenon. Electrode processes. Electrodes. In electrolysis, we know that at electrodes, during electrolysis, metals may be deposited on the cathode or anode. Metals may be deposited on the electrodes. Gases may be released at the electrodes. or sometimes substances may undergo reaction at the electrodes. All these processes occur at the surface or interface. In this chapter, we mainly focus on three topics. In that, first one, adsorption. Second one, catalysis. Third one, colloids. Adsorption, catalysis, colloids. Let's see each topic in detail. In that first chapter, adsorption. In surface chemistry, the first part, adsorption. What is the definition for adsorption? When I write some words on this board with this marker pen, the molecules of ink just they concentrate or accumulate on the surface of board. These molecules do not enter into the bulk of board. They do not penetrate into the board. That is adsorption. So what is adsorption? Accumulation of particles of one substance on the surface of another substance is called adsorption. So adsorption is, it is accumulation of particles of one substance over the surface of another substance. Over the surface of another substance. See a picture showing adsorption. This is some adsorbent. So this is a substance on whose surface some molecules are adsorbed. So here this is, let it be substance B. This bulky substance A. So here what happened? Molecules of B are gathered or collected or accumulated on the surface of A. So this type of accumulation of particles of one substance over the surface of another substance is called adsorption. Okay. You know, adsorption is a surface phenomenon. It is a surface phenomenon. Surface phenomenon means occurs only on the surface, not in the bulk. Occurs only in the on the surface. In adsorption phenomenon, there are two components involved. One is surface providing substance, other one is surface reaching substance. So they are named separately. The substance which provides surface for the adsorption is called adsorbent. A substance which provides surface for the adsorption process is called what? Adsorbent. Adsorption involves two components. One is surface providing, other one is surface reaching. You know, a substance which provides a surface for the adsorption is called adsorbent. What is adsorbent? Which provides the surface. For the adsorption process, the another substance is called adsorbate. What is adsorbate? The substance whose molecules concentrate on the surface of adsorbent is called adsorbate. So what is adsorbates? What is adsorbate? Which particles of which concentrate? Particles of which concentrate on the surface of adsorbent. Particles of which concentrate on the surface of adsorbent is called adsorbate. See, in this picture, particles of B are concentrating on the surface of A. So here adsorbent is A, adsorbate is B. What is adsorbent here? A, because it is providing the surface for adsorption. What is adsorbate? B. Why? Its molecules are reaching on the surface of adsorbate. So in that way, we can define adsorbate and adsorbent. Let's see some examples for adsorbate and